Good morning, everybody. I'm gonna be honest, I've been laughing for like the last 15 minutes. So remember how I said Pogo would probably be next? Nah, they did it this update. And yeah, it's triple splashdown. I don't know how this is gonna sound, so I'll try to keep it quiet. I'm still on the scuffed setup. I'm really about to leave. And both End Parry and Custom Blaster have triple splashdown. And I will cover this special in more detail when I do my analysis of the patch tomorrow. I'm just going to include both. But for now, what you need to know is basically when you splash down, you get two fists that move with you in front of you, and all three of them land. You can shoot the fists down in the same way you could a splash down. I don't know if they have less health. I imagine they probably would. And you can still splash down jump. And of course, since the fists can die, you better believe so can the splash down get shot down. I do have a few questions. I'm wondering how much of the meteor you retain when you land. By the way, Bluefin has a moving zone. That's so fucking cool. I'm sorry. And, yeah, so I find it funny that like dualies have three splashdown rework weapons in one, which is hilarious, but to be honest, it might not be as bad. One cooler means you can retain splashdown if you die, if you still keep some of it, if you get shut down, maybe that could be good. You still have cooler QSJ as well. And cooler special saver. So if you die in splashdown, you could jump in with a splashdown jump, or you could QSJ splashdown jump. So you have some more options than cooler anyway. I think cooler's like even more essential for splashdown than anything else. But yeah, the Pogo triple splashdown theory was correct all along. It's just your two other splashdowns are fists. It does feel kind of weird having Reef Slider. And also, I think with these buffs that splashdown is better now. So it makes it even more funny that we have Reef Slider in the game. I hope it gets buffed, and I hope they do some more distinction of a buff to make it different, because I feel like otherwise it would have been better to just replace every splashdown weapon, every slider weapon, but anyway, memes aside, again, I'll try to do a better analysis of it when I cover the patch that's probably gonna release tonight. That way we can talk about both of them. I just realized I didn't resize my screen from playing on the TV. So, my bad. I guess this is going to be extra scuffed. But yeah, so let's talk about the weapons themselves. So, first off, we have the End Parry Splat Dooley with Splashdown and Curling Bomb. Now, I think this is basically going to be an incredibly aggressive rushdown dually. Like, I think this is going to be a dually that literally wants to play like a Tetra and just throw curling bomb, run forward, double dodge roll, get in your face, use the triple splashdown, like, basically knowing you're probably going to die and just trying to do as much damage and paint as possible. Like, this is very much going to be a hold forward weapon. Splashdown's not an entry tool at all. I think that's pretty obvious. So you're pretty much just using this for hard kills and playing a QR build compared to the vanilla dually, which might still be good with how good of a main weapon dualies are right now. And if splashdown does guarantee some damage, then I think it could be fun. You do still lose like both the lethal bomb and entry tool, so I think the vanilla kit will undoubtedly be better and more used. Like, I don't know, maybe I could see it. I could see maybe like Rainmaker, especially when the triple splashdown might be able to be used behind the Rainmaker shield for insane DPS if like all three of them do somewhat amount of damage. We have to see how much they actually do. I've just realized the possibility that the triple splashdown might not one shot or the outside hitboxes might have to combo. Let's not think about that. So, you know, End Parry I think will be like okay at worst. I don't think it's going to be that bad. Custom Blaster, on the other hand, yeah, I don't know. You're trading off Autobomb for Point Sensor, which is like not a great trade for a blaster. So you're not going to get a lot of special anyway. And considering, you know, it's a splashdown where you will need to refarm another one at times and get it back, I feel like the ability to quickly charge it, especially with stuff like cooler, is important. Maybe it won't be as bad. Maybe you'll die and basically have splashdown instantly when you respawn. I don't know. The other thing is Dooley has a lot of mobility to like roll around or use the curling before it jumps into the sky and splashdown. I can't believe I'm talking about splashdown in this game before splashdowns. And this weapon really doesn't. Its splashdowns are going to be a lot more predictable of the two. So I think it's going to be a bit more difficult for it to get them off. And like Bubble is fine on it, and Bubble's like pretty decent right now still. Like Bubble's kind of ended up in this pretty solid middle ground type special. And so I don't know, I think the V-Blast kit has gone from like relatively weak to pretty, I want to say a bit more above average. I still don't think it's that good, but like it's not bad either. And I think it's probably better than the Custom Blast. So I think if we do see Triple Splashdown, I think it's probably going to be on End Parry and not this. But, you know, maybe we'll see it a bit on Tower, or maybe Triple Splashdown is somehow really good. And, yeah, I mean, I don't have too much analysis because really the special just got shown and I have to break down the special itself, but it won't be long until we get the weapons, so we'll see. But I believe this is going to be all the weapons. We'll get that confirmed with the patch later. So this is it for the season. 9 kits and 2 specials. So not bad in terms of content. I mean, the previous season had 9 kits counting the 2 new main weapons. So, or not 9 kits. I think it was it 11 counting the 2 new kits, and I don't know. I'm a bit rambly. Sorry. It is like super early in the morning, but I do wonder how this game is going to deal with all these specials, having 19 specials in the game. If there's no third kits, I think we might have a problem, like a bigger problem now, because I don't see how these new specials are going to be on a lot of weapons if there's only 2 seasons more to add them. Like, I guess you could add 2 on every weapon in for both of them in both seasons. Oh, that's nice. And just go from there, but I'm not sure. It feels like it's going to be a bit too spread out, and I would kind of wish there would be more options for all the specials and stuff in the game, and that's kind of how I feel about kits in general. So I'm a little bit worried about this long term, but you know, in the short term, it seems like a smarter splashdown rework than Reef Slider, so you know, that's fair at least. And it's still funny. I think it's going to be funny for a long time. But I'll do my best to get some analysis of it. And again, I'll get that out as early as I can tomorrow. I'll combine it with the patch video. And yeah. It's we really have splashdown in this game, and it's not the worst special in the game, so I think anyway. Anyway, I hope you guys enjoy. I am so ready for this season, dude. There is a lot for me specifically. I'll see you guys next time.